Let's feed in this radiant face and see what we get. A young man with glasses is standing outside, smiling at the camera. He has curly hair and a blue shirt. And we get bounding boxes. Interesting. This is the output from KOSMOS-2, a new paper released 48 hours ago by Microsoft Research. It is the latest work in a series from Microsoft that has the goal of advancing AGI for humanity. In this video, I'll describe the work, offer some of my thoughts on it, and show some examples where it doesn't quite work as expected. I'll also talk about the ethics statement, which I found particularly interesting here. KOSMOS-2 is described as a multimodal large language model, or MLLM, enabling new capabilities of perceiving object descriptions, for example, bounding boxes, and grounding text to the visual world. It's a model that can take in a combination of an image and a text prompt that in this case uses the term it and links it to a specific region of the image containing a friendly looking snowman. So the prompt is it sits next to. And then from here, the model is able to perform a completion that includes both the relevant text, a campfire, and its location in the image as a bounding box. You can immediately see that this is a very general and flexible formulation that allows the model to point to things in images. As the observant among you will have noticed, KOSMOS-2 builds on previous work, KOSMOS-1, also from Microsoft, way back in those halcyon days of spring 2023, before the dawn of GPT-4. KOSMOS-1 was similar in spirit to Flamingo. It could take in interleaved text and images, and output text. This work wasn't afraid of tearing up the rulebook. They had a full first page figure, then a quote from Wittgenstein, and then the abstract. Strong. It showed solid zero-shot image captioning results, as well as good zero-shot visual question answering performance. Jumping back to KOSMOS-2, the way that the authors add the ability to point to objects in the input and output is to represent referring expressions as links in Markdown, i.e. square brackets containing a text span, and parentheses containing bounding boxes, where object descriptions are sequences of location tokens. Let's see some examples of KOSMOS-2 in action. Given a prompt consisting of this image and the text, the left eye of emoji, the model produces an appropriate bounding box. Here, the prompt has this image and text saying, question, how many cows are here? Answer, we get the output text, two cows present in the image. And the phrase two cows is linked to appropriate bounding boxes. The model can also perform relative comparisons. Here, the input consists of this image with bounding boxes and the linked text. Question, what is the biggest difference between bottle 1 and bottle 2? Answer, and KOSMOS-2 outputs, the biggest difference between bottle 1 and bottle 2 is the label. Impressive. The key claim of this work is that the authors unlock the grounding capability for multimodal large language models. This is useful because it enables the user to point to the object or region in the image directly, rather than input detailed text descriptions to refer to it. Grounding capability also enables the model to respond with visual answers, i.e. bounding boxes, as we saw with the cow counting and the emoji face earlier. Like KOSMOS-1, KOSMOS-2 is a transformer-based causal language model and is trained using the next word prediction task. To train KOSMOS-2 on grounding data, one of the contributions of this work is to build the grounded image text pairs, or GRIT, dataset. This is built upon a subset of image text pairs from the Lion2B dataset and the Koyo 700 million dataset. The GRIT dataset is built in two steps. Step 1, generating noun chunk bounding box pairs. Suppose we start from a captioned image, like this charming image, with the caption, a dog in a field of flowers. The first step is to identify the noun chunks. That gives us a dog, and a field, and flowers. These are plugged into GLIP to produce bounding boxes for a dog and a field. In step 2, the goal is producing referring expression bounding box pairs. Here, the noun chunk is expanded by looking at the dependency tree. So, a dog is expanded to a dog in a field of flowers, a field is expanded to a field of flowers, and flowers is still just flowers. Some post-processing is performed to drop redundant substrings, and then the bounding box generated earlier is combined with the referring expression. With this automatic processing, Secret ends up containing 90 million images and 137 million objects. You can see that that's quite large relative to previous datasets. Now we come to KOSMOS-2 itself, a grounded multimodal large language model. Not much has changed here. KOSMOS-2 adopts the same model architecture and training objective as KOSMOS-1. One part that's different is now we need some way for the model to represent bounding boxes. This is done with discrete location tokens in the style of pix2seq. There are p by p location tokens that live on a grid. Boxes are then represented with their top left and bottom right corner points. A special dlim token is used to separate boxes if there are multiple. Then p tags are used to mimic hyperlinks in Markdown so that we can create sequences of tokens that represent image embeddings and text that is linked to bounding boxes. Let's move on to model training. When combining the new dataset with data used from KOSMOS-1 and taking 60k steps, KOSMOS-2 is trained on the equivalent of around 25 billion tokens, including repeats. This is done on 256 V100 GPUs, which takes approximately one day to complete. The image resolution is set to 224 by 224 pixels, and the patch size is 14 by 14. To start from a good place, KOSMOS-2 uses the weights of KOSMOS-1 for initialization, and the newly added word embeddings of location tokens are initialized randomly. As with other models, the authors use instruction tuning by combining the vision language instruction dataset, Lava Instruct, and language-only instruction datasets, i.e. unnatural instructions and FLAN V2, which is combined with the training data to tune the model. KOSMOS-2 can be evaluated on many tasks: multimodal grounding, multimodal referring, perception language tasks, and language tasks. I'll try out the model first with some images I pick myself. I'm not sure if the demo allows you to put text in the prompt. I wasn't able to figure it out, so we'll just feed in images as input. Here's an image I've cunningly composed. Let's send it to the model. KOSMOS-2 thinks the image features a pair of black sneakers sitting on top of a shoebox. The sneakers are placed on a beige carpet, and the box is placed on the floor. Now, we do get a good box for the sneakers and the shoebox. But you might observe a couple of things here. First, it's only one shoe. Second, if the model could read robustly, it could infer that the box is a multi-pack of Diet Coke with refreshing taste, no calories, no sugar. It has captured the relation of the black sneakers on top of the shoebox, although it's not a shoebox, and the fact that the box is placed on the floor. The caption from KOSMOS-2 sounds plausible as a sentence, but it contains hallucinations of things that are not there. I saw this effect documented previously in the Flamingo work from DeepMind, where they highlighted several examples of hallucinations, where the language model may override the visual model. For example, given this image and the text, question, what can you see out the window? Answer, Flamingo responds with, a parking lot. What the deuce? There is no window. I'll try one more image. This is also quite challenging. It's a photo from the Oxford-Cambridge boat race. Here we go. This time, the image depicts a group of 8 men rowing in a boat on a river. They are all wearing matching blue shirts and black vests, and they are all focused on their rowing. The boat is positioned in the middle of the river, and the men are all rowing in unison. The scene takes place near a brick wall, adding to the urban atmosphere of the scene. So, the model picks up on elements of the scene, but again, the language model prior appears to play a major role here. It appears to know that it should look for 8 rowers, because these are rowing boats, but there aren't 8 rowers visible. There are also 2 boats rather than 1, and although it's quite likely that they are somewhere near the middle of the river, I would claim that's difficult to infer from this photograph. Can't argue with the urban atmosphere of the scene though, that's a nice touch. The model also seems to match the blue shirts from Oxford with the blue shirts from Cambridge. An unconscionable error. Qualitatively, I think KOSMOS-2 shows the potential to tackle these tasks, but is still quite a long way from achieving it robustly. That being said, I have deliberately given it difficult images to push the model to its limits. I'll move on now to the formal evaluations. Let's start with phrase grounding. Here, the task is to feed in some image and some text, and ask the model to produce a bounding box for some part of it, in this case the orange safety vest. In the phrase grounding results on Flickr 30k entities, KOSMOS-2 gets by far the strongest zero-shot results, significantly outperforming Grill but still behind the strongest fine-tuned methods. Now let's look at referring expression comprehension, where the referring expression can be a little more complicated. As before, we feed in an image, but now the model is requested to provide a bounding box for a more complex referring expression. In this case, the model should output a bounding box for a man in a blue hard hat and orange safety vest. On Ref Coco, Ref Coco Plus, and Ref Coco G, COSMOS-2 is again the best zero-shot method, and again, trails behind fine-tuned methods, as you might expect. When looking at zero-shot image captioning results on Flickr 30K, we can see that COSMOS-2 outperforms prior works like COSMOS-1, Flamingo 3B, and Flamingo 9B. The larger Flamingo model is not included in this table for some reason. The largest Flamingo model actually scores slightly higher, 67.2. It may be that the COSMOS-2 authors felt that it was an unfair comparison due to the model size, or perhaps for some other factor, but it does seem odd to exclude it without providing justification, particularly since this table gives the impression that COSMOS-2 is the state of the art. Of course, the point of COSMOS-2 is not necessarily to improve on these results, but rather to demonstrate the ability to do new tasks. Still, it remains a little odd. If I was peer reviewing the paper, an eyebrow would be raised. If I had to guess, I would assume it occurs because the comparison in the COSMOS-1 paper only includes the smaller Flamingo models. In COSMOS-1, the authors highlight the fact that their model is able to outperform Flamingo 3B and Flamingo 9B with a smaller size of 1.6 billion parameters. So given the size disparity, perhaps they felt it was unfair to compare to the largest Flamingo model. But if that's true, why compare to Flamingo 9B? Jumping back to COSMOS-2, presumably the same rationale is used to choose which models to include in the comparison. Finally, there are experiments looking at performance on language tasks. Here, comparisons are made with an LLM that uses the same text data and training setup to re-implement a language model as COSMOS-1 and with COSMOS-1 itself. COSMOS-2 is roughly in the same ballpark here, doing a little better on some datasets like BoolQ and dropping behind on others, like Commitment Bank. We now reach the ethics statement. Here, we find that the model presented in this paper is intended for academic and research purposes. That is fair enough, well within bounds. The accountability for any improper or unacceptable application of the model rests exclusively with the individuals who generated such content. I think this statement is interesting in the context of recent papers, such as an overview of catastrophic AI risks, which suggests that there should be legal liability for developers of general purpose AIs. We'll have to see how this dynamic develops. Finally, the COSMOS-2 authors say that we also put Microsoft AI principles into practice when developing the models. That sounds good. What are Microsoft AI principles? The principles include fairness, reliability and safety, privacy and security, inclusiveness, transparency, and accountability. Given the specific claim that these were put into practice, it would be interesting to know how. For example, transparency here means that AI systems should be understandable. COSMOS-2 is a deep neural network with more than a billion parameters trained on many millions of images that were annotated automatically. Is COSMOS-2 an AI system that is understandable? I think the authors are entitled to make a case that COSMOS-2 is understandable, but it is not described in the paper. These critiques aside, I think that COSMOS-2 does likely represent, at least directionally, the future for computer vision. It's an example of a system that maps complex grounding tasks onto the transformer architecture and trains at scale. Bear in mind that we are still talking about much less compute here than is used to train the most powerful language models. So with deployment of further capital, which I expect we will see, the performance may improve significantly as further computational resources are added. The authors say that their work lays out the foundation for the development of embodiment AI and sheds light on the big convergence of language, multimodal perception, action, and world modeling, which is a key step toward artificial general intelligence. As a proof of concept for how to tackle multimodal grounding in a scalable way, I am inclined to agree. The demo is live, so you can try that out for yourself. The model checkpoints are to be uploaded, so perhaps check back soon. That's it. We've reached the end. Thank you for your attention. I hope you have a wonderful day.